This is The Street Life.
I'll play the street life
with Greg Russell. A program here to eliminate the stigma and address the issues that can affect your community. And now, The Street Life with Greg Russell.
All right, what's going on, Atlanta? What's going on? We're here. I'm your host, Greg, with another episode of Street Life. All right, I got a guest today in the building coming to us, well, yeah, from California, really. But I spent most of her time in California, a longtime friend. And we're going to talk about how she has managed to open up or found a way to make her own money. So this is my guest here, Miss Lolita Korneagay.
Hello, hello, everyone.
How you doing today?
I am doing wonderful. How are you?
I'm well. I'm glad that you're here. So we got some positive stuff going on. You're doing a lot of great stuff, actually. I've looked at your posts. You're just all over the board.
I am. Yeah.
So you're in California. How is that for you?
I love Los Angeles. I've been there for about 12 years now, and
really?
That is home for me. I do still love Atlanta because I am a Southern girl, though.
Oh, Atlanta's still home.
Right. Atlanta's still home.
Yeah. All right. So tell us a little bit about your business. You have a Nurse CEO. How did you start that?
So Nurse CEO is a passion project of mine. I've been a nurse for 14 years now, but I've also always been an entrepreneur.
Okay.
And so what I realized was that there's no education for nurses regarding how to become business owners or entrepreneurs.
You're right about
that. So what Nurse CEO does is we try to bridge the gap between being a nurse and owning your own business.
And then how does that look, like bridging the gap? How do you, you know, make the difference or even handle the two?
Well, the cool thing about most nurses is they have a lot of flexible time, because if they're still doing bedside nursing, they're doing 12-hour shifts or 10-hour shifts, so they have 3 to 4 days off per week. So during those 3 to 4 days off, they can have what we call a side hustle.
Okay.
And during that side hustle, you can make some extra money, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
We all need that in these streets nowadays. Holidays are coming up,
right.
So we need that extra side money.
Yeah, but the problem is that the nurses, they know what they want to do, but they just don't know how to do it, how to turn their side hustle into a money-making business.
Yeah, yeah. So how did you fall into teaching others how to do that?
Oh, you know, God, it works in mysterious ways, right? Over the years, I've actually been a nursing student teacher. It kind of fell into my lap. And then I also taught nurses in hospitals how to use medical devices. So I've always been teaching over the past 14 years.
Okay.
And so since I started my own businesses, I realized that I can use my teaching experience to teach nurses specifically
right.
how to own businesses.
Okay. And all right, well, I just want to dig deeper into it.
Go
now,
for it.
How does that look? How does it start for somebody to try to own their own business? You're working 9 to 5, like you said, these 12 or 10 hours.
Mm-hmm.
How did you manage, or what ways did you take to overcome all of this?
Well, first you have to have an idea, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And then you have to have a passion for that idea. So it can't simply be, I just want to make some money. It has to be like, I have a passion for this, and I want to dedicate all my extra time that normally I would spend watching Real Housewives.
Right,
I'm going
right.
to take that time, and I'm now going to dedicate it to building my business.
And we do have those who just always repeating, oh, yeah, I want to change this.
Exactly.
I want to change this.
Yeah.
And they have ideas of wanting to do something.
Right.
And they tell everybody else about it. So 5 or 10 years later, what you see them? They're
yep.
right back in the same situation.
Yep.
Yeah. So with teaching, all right, so Nurse CEO, you had an idea, you had a plan,
mm-hmm.
and you went through, you followed through with it,
mm-hmm.
right? And teaching everybody else the platform,
mm-hmm.
where did it start? Like just on the job? Alone, or do you reach out to other side people or other people to engage with?
So I personally built my own platform.
Okay.
So I started from scratch. I didn't have any followers. I didn't have anything. It was just me and my idea, right?
Really?
Yeah, it was from ground zero.
Okay.
And the first thing that I did was I created a free course. So I created a course called Find Your Focus, which is for nurses who they're thinking about starting a business, but they don't really know what they want to do or how they want to do it.
Right.
So they take the free course, it's Find Your Focus, and it helps them focus in on exactly what they want to do. So I created that. And after I created that, I started to get subscribers and followers and nurses who wanted me to mentor them and coach them.
Wow.
So I literally built it from the ground up.
And how long did that take?
Actually, not long. Less than a year.
Really?
Yeah, so
there are a lot of people that really want to open their own business.
It is.
Yeah.
What's interesting is I think I just had my 1 year nurse CEO anniversary, and
congratulations.
I am now bi-coastal. That's why I'm in Atlanta now.
Okay, okay. Well, I'm glad that you're here. That's a good thing, man. We need more people. We need to empower more people in doing so. Everybody can make some money.
Yes.
Everybody can make some money. And then we get ourselves caught into this 9-to-5 rat race, always looking for the next dollar or chasing our tails, basically, I call it.
Yes.
You know, paying one check to one check.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you found a way to get yourself free of this rat race.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Now, do you have employees or do you still go out and teach?
No, so I have another company where it's a nurse case management company, and I specialize in workers' compensation, and I have national clients all over the United States, and I do employ a few nurses to work underneath me.
You are busy.
I am busy. Yeah.
Yeah. You are busy. Hey, if somebody needs a job or needs to learn how to
so
start
that's,
their own business,
right.
Here you are. This is Miss Lolita Korneagay, guys. Do you have any information that you can share with everybody that they can follow you and actually start looking?
Yeah. Yeah. So if you're a nurse, and actually what's interesting is that I focus on nurses because I'm a nurse, but really the information that I give my nurses, anyone could benefit from, right? Because
right,
if you want to start a business, it's universal. It's not just for nurses. So even if you're not a nurse, you can still follow me and maybe you can get some wonderful tips.
Yeah.
So on all social media, I am the Nurse CEO.
The Nurse CEO.
Yes, that's me.
There's nothing else behind it.
The Nurse CEO.
That's it. That's the good stuff. Like I said, I've seen a lot of your postings, a lot of your pictures, and it amazes me how it starts from a small idea.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It starts from a small idea. We've been taking off with street life here. It's a famous question I ask everybody. So when you hear the term street life, what do you think of?
I think of street life to me sounds real and raw, right?
Right.
So it sounds like what is happening out on the streets? What is the average everyday person doing on an everyday basis?
Right. Yeah. And that's what it is. It's still a struggle. Mm-hmm. And it's all about survival.
Oh, absolutely.
It's all about survival.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Miss Lolita Korneagay. We're going to take a quick break right now, and then we're going to come on back in.
The sinister cries haunted Mary through the night. Dawn neared, and still the voice tormented her. She ran towards the safety of her car, flung open the door, and a coyote had somehow gotten locked inside. But the damaged interior was covered, thanks to Farmers Insurance. Coyote Carpool, August 1st, 2015. Talk to a farmer's agent. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Call Todd Tettleton at the Tettleton Agency for Farmers Insurance at 404-327-6377.
Hi there, healthy people. Do you have a healthy product or service? If you are a certified medical professional, fitness trainer, author, or chef, Old Fashioned Health would love to promote your services or product on the Old Fashioned Health Radio Show. Please reach out to us. Call 404-793-3960. Or email us at oldfashionedhealth@gmail.com. You can also contact us at oldfashionedhealth.com. Old Fashioned Health, good health inside and out.
Done. Don't play with a dog, be dishonest. Ay. Still not understanding this logic. Hey, I'm back and I'm better. Want you bad as ever. Don't let me just let up. I wanna give you better.
baby, it's whatever. Somebody gotta step up on that. Somebody's on next up. Be damn if I let them catch up. It's easy to see that you're fed up. I am on a whole nother level. Girl, he fought you over cause you let him. Girl, I guess you didn't know any better. Girl, that man didn't show any effort. Do all I can just to show you you're special. Certain it's your love that holds me together. Lately, you say he been killing the vibe. Gotta be sick of this guy. Pull up the skirt, get in the right. Left hand is steering, the other is gripping your thigh. Light up a spiff and get high. Shawty, who deserve a true man isn't. Looking at you, I'm thinking he must be tripping. Play this song for me, just listen.
All right, guys, welcome back. Welcome back. This is The Real 1100 AM. I am your host, Greg, and we are kicking it in the studio with Miss Lolita Korneagay. I had a question for you. So, in California, what part of California you live in?
Los Angeles, downtown Los Angeles.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a crazy question because people ask you where you're from, and they're like, okay, where in California? You've never been. You've never been to California, but you always ask somebody, where? Yeah, right. Where, right?
Right.
Yeah, so we're talking about your businesses. You'd opened up one, Nurse CEO. Mm-hmm. Now you've actually turned around and opened up another business.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us a little bit about that. And then you have a story to go with it, too.
Yeah, of course. You know, I am a serial entrepreneur. I've been doing this since third grade, so it's just in my blood. But my new business is Cansoom. It is a cannabis educational company.
All right, now watch out now.
So, yes, I had to join the cannabis space because it's new in so many places. Recreational cannabis is coming, is legalized in so many states right now.
Yes.
And California is slated to be the capital of the world for recreational cannabis use.
Are you serious?
Yes, I am serious.
Wow, just because it's a lot, it's a bigger state?
Yeah, because of the population.
Oh, okay.
Yes, we have more people per capita than anywhere else as far as recreational cannabis use will go.
So what is the process that you had to go through to be legal or be certified to actually handle this?
Okay, so for me, I am what's called non-plant touching. So I don't actually touch the cannabis plant. I provide the education regarding the cannabis plant.
Okay.
Because of that, I don't have to have a special licensure, right?
Right.
However, I did create an entire program for licensed medical professionals to teach them how to become certified cannabis consultants.
Really?
Yes, I did.
So you just teach them how to use it?
So I teach them everything in the background. I teach them the history of cannabis. I teach them about the endocannabinoid system. I teach them about the routes of administration. I teach them about treatment plans, dosages, and how they can consult with clients all over the world to do the same.
Wow. And what about the benefits? Do you also explain that?
Yes, of course.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I am a cannabis advocate now.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Gotcha. And how long has this been going on?
So, it's funny because October of last year, I went to an accelerator, a business accelerator in Miami for a week with Angela Benton, who is a Silicon Valley investor.
Okay.
And so she helped me flesh out a lot of these ideas.
Right.
And when I came back from that accelerator for 1 week, I was gung-ho and ready to go.
Really?
And I officially launched my program in September of this year. So about a year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Hey, you're still rolling.
I am. I don't waste time.
Hey, why would you? And also, you said this business was approved by AHNA. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yes. So, one important thing is that I needed to get it peer-reviewed and board-certified.
What does that mean?
So, that means that my peers, other nurses, have reviewed my program and my curriculum, and they have put their stamp of approval on it to say, this is good to go. We approve you to actually hand out continuing education credits to other nurses who take this course, and we approve you to be one of our endorsed programs, and that is through the American Holistic Nurses Association. And I am the very first cannabis course that ever existed.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Through them, yeah.
That's big. Yes, you are.
Yeah.
That's good. So now, how many people have have actually joined up or signed up for
this? Okay. So like I said, I just launched it in September. In my very first class, we had about 5 nurses there from all over the country. We had Texas, Louisiana, Maryland. We had nurses fly into California just to take this course.
Wow.
The next 2 courses will be in January and February, and I have nurses signed up from all over the country and Canada. Who will be coming down to take the course.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I hear you now. I hear you. Well, do you ever get feedback about the usage of cannabis or the negativity anytime?
Yeah, so one reason that I started the Cansoom program is because I hate the negative stigma that is attached to cannabis use, right?
Okay.
And even growing up, I'm a preacher's kid, right? So
I
always thought it was a bad thing myself. It wasn't until I learned the history behind it and I learned how natural of a plant, literally a plant it is, that it's better than, and plus being a nurse, you know, I tell my patients all the time to take all of these synthetic pharmaceutical drugs when they're reality, sometimes a all-natural plant could be the solution to the problem.
Okay, so tell us some of the benefits.
Okay, it just depends. It's a plethora. Some people want to call it a miracle plant because it helps so many different ailments and issues, right?
Well, some people say it clears up glaucoma or something like that.
Right. So we already know there's been testing that shows how beneficial it is with curing cancer, right?
Okay.
Skin disorders like eczema, psoriasis, if you have PTSD, if you have stress, anxiety, the list can go on and on.
Wow, that is big.
Right.
Yes. And then a lot of people just don't even know.
They think that they... So for me, my issue was I had a lot of medical issues going on in my life.
Okay.
And I didn't want to take pharmaceutical drugs. Even as a nurse, I didn't want to take it because I knew how damaging...
I was about to ask you about that. You're a nurse and then you didn't want to take...
I did not because I know... Look at the opioid crisis we have right now.
Yeah, that's
right?
That is serious.
I'm like, I don't want any part of that. So it was just like, what can I do? And so I turned to cannabis to help myself personally. But what I realized was that during my exploration of cannabis, there was so much I didn't know.
Okay.
And I had to educate myself first.
Right.
And during that education process, which was 20 months to be exact.
Wow. That's a long time.
It was a super long time. I figured other people, millions of people are having the same issues and they want help, but they don't want to spend 20 months trying to figure it out.
Yeah.
So I make it easy.
A lot of people just want instant gratification.
Instant.
Yeah.
But if they come to me, I make it easy because I already did the work and I wrote the book.
And a book?
And a book.
Oh, okay. back up. We didn't know about the book.
Right,
so introduce the book to us.
So the cannabis, the book, there's actually 2, I guess you can say, and they're currently being edited. So the first book is The Medical Consultant's Cannabis Handbook. So it is for licensed medical professionals. They can read the book and they can also learn how they can help their patients use cannabis. The second one is a cannabis consultant journal. It is for the everyday person that uses cannabis, but they need to track their cannabis consumption.
So I guess a lot of too much of anything is not good for you.
Well, no. So the thing is, cannabis is not a science. It's an art. Right? So sometimes you use this, it may work. You may use something else, it may work differently. So the only way that you can come up with a true plan for yourself is to write it down and to journal and to see what worked, how much worked, what didn't work, you know, and that way you can look back over it and say, I used this on Tuesday, it helped. I used this on Thursday, it didn't help. And now you have a journal of what works for you.
Yeah. Some people just, well, I don't know. I'm not a guy who just writes down in a journal every day. You know, I think it's more or less just go with the flow. I think that's how it's trained. Just go with the flow. No, but we do have to make a plan in order for it to work out.
Long-term use. I'm talking about long-term use.
Long-term, right.
Not short-term gratification.
So explain the difference between, you know, your cannabis on the streets that you have people selling versus the medical cannabis.
Right. Okay. So the difference is the lab testing. So anything that's sold in a dispensary currently should be lab tested. And so you should be able to flip that product over, whatever it is, and you should be able to see exactly what's in there. And plus, you can see if there's any bad things like molds, pesticides, bacteria growing in that cannabis, which you do not want to put into your body. The things that are on the street, they're not lab tested nor regulated. So you know that you're getting flower, but how pure of a flower is that?
Right.
You don't know.
Don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know. And you... Yeah, that's scary. You get a bag and then you just all the way messed up. Now you right. really need some help.
Did somebody put something in there? Right. You know, like you don't know. And that's why I always recommend if you're going to use cannabis, go to a dispensary and use products that are regulated and lab tested.
Yeah, yeah. So lab tested, then are they adding anything to it?
Can you clarify? What do you mean?
All right, so the cannabis is being certified in the lab uh-huh. or lab tested. Uh-huh. Are they adding anything to it or taking anything away from it?
Both. So the cool thing about the cannabis products now, and so when I mean cannabis products, I just don't mean the flower or the bud that you're used to. I mean the whole wide range of products from vape pens to edibles to topicals to transdermals to suppositories to whatever, right?
Right, right.
And so with those products, the breeders that are growing the cannabis now are doing some amazing things that will blow your mind. Okay. So yes, in the breeding process, they're adding beneficial things to it. So they're increasing the terpene profiles, right?
Okay.
They're increasing the CBD levels. They're decreasing the THC levels. They're literally creating Frankenstein kind of cannabis that will do exactly what they wanted to do, but in an all natural way.
Okay, okay. Well, you have these vape shops, you know, mm-hmm. a lot of them now, mm-hmm. and they may have a vape oil CBD.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now, would that benefit you in any kind of way, or that's just a regular type of oil? I mean, I'm just trying to understand.
Oh, absolutely. So THC and CBD are what we call cannabinoids. So that's just one part of the cannabis plant. The cannabis plant actually has 113 cannabinoids, right? So your face is like, what?
Yeah,
right.
That's a big
so
number.
It's a big number. But most people are only aware of THC and CBD because right. those are the most popular, right?
Right.
So CBD is beneficial. If you're getting pure lab-tested CBD, it will add beneficial benefits medically, you know, and recreationally, I guess,
right.
If you use it. So, yes, if it's a true CBD product.
Well, we're not saying go out and buy it or anything like that, all right? We're just trying to get some clarification on the difference and the benefits behind it.
Right.
Let's
right.
make that correction.
Right. Yeah, you want it, but one thing I do want to say to people is hemp is not the same thing as marijuana.
And people do get that confused.
They do all yeah. the time. I hear hemp oil, and it bothers me so much when I hear about hemp oil.
Right.
Simply because hemp is grown for industrial purposes.
Oh, like clothing?
Clothing, rope, sails. It has a whole bunch of uses, but hemp is for industrial purposes. Marijuana is not for industrial purposes.
Gotcha, mm-hmm. gotcha. Yeah, you can't make any clothes out of that one.
Right.
You can't make any clothes out of that one.
So don't, and then if someone's mailing you hemp oil in the mail and it's all legal, which is true because it doesn't have any THC and it has very little CBD in it, that's the reason why it's legal. Because there's really no benefit to it.
Wow. Okay.
Don't waste your money.
So you were also, in one of your posts, you were talking about how to use it without lighting up.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, when everybody hear about it, that's all they know.
Yeah, and so when I first started using cannabis, I was 100% against smoking it. I'm not a smoker. I did not want to smoke it. I did not want to light a blunt or a joint, anything. I was like, I'm not doing it.
Right.
So I found so many other ways that you can use it without lighting up. Like I say, they have patches you can just simply stick on your shoulder.
Get
no one
here.
Even knows that you're walking around with a patch on, right?
Get out of here.
Isn't that cool? They have Epsom salt with cannabis in it. You can soak your feet in cannabis, okay?
Wow.
They have lotions.
See, they're doing a lot. They're doing a lot in California. None of that is happening here in Atlanta. None of that is happening here.
Yeah, it's amazing the things that they're doing, and I just want to bring awareness so that people
and you
know
the same benefits through all of this.
Yep, the exact same benefits. And actually, if you smoke it, you get less benefit if you smoke it.
And why is that?
Because once you light it, which means you're combusting it, then you're releasing carcinogens. The same carcinogens that are in cigarettes can come from the smoke from lighting
but
marijuana.
But it's supposed to be all natural.
It is, but I'm saying once you combust it,
uh-huh.
that's when you start to release the bad things, right?
Oh.
And also, 76% of marijuana that is smoked is lost to the room. So that's why it's just floating in the air and you're not actually receiving all of those benefits inside of your body.
Okay.
You're wasting product is what we call it.
No, you get sleepy, hungry. I mean, are the side effects fine? Well, because it's a wave going on. And like we discussed earlier, there are a lot of states that's actually that are legalizing marijuana right now.
Mm-hmm. Over 30.
Over 30 now.
Mm-hmm. As far as medically, and then recreationally, I think there's 10.
That's a lot.
That's a lot.
That is a lot.
We're almost halfway there.
Almost.
We just need federal. Once it becomes federally legal, we're good to go.
Then we're good to go.
Yeah.
So with that, that's why I asked, are there any side effects? Because it's becoming a wave.
Mm-hmm. Right. So for me, what I caution my patients and my friends and stuff is that you do not want to overindulge, right? So that means that you're using too much of the product. And once you use too much, that's when you're getting the bad side effects like hallucinations. Mm-hmm. You know, that's when you may actually vomit. Mm-hmm. That's when you may become, you know, all of the bad things happen when you use too much of it.
Right, right.
But if you use just the right amount, you're good to go. But if you overindulge, you'll start to see those negative side effects.
Okay. Yeah. So I guess it's worked out for you since you started doing what you were doing.
Uh-huh.
All right. Back in good health?
Yeah, I am 100% pain-free. I'm happy. My quality of life has greatly improved, and I hope to improve millions of other people's quality of life also.
You're on your way. So tell everybody where we can find that information as well.
Okay. So cansoom.com. That's CANSOOM, like you can consume.com.
All right. Do we have a number behind it?
No, just the website. And on that website, we have a directory. So you can find local medical consultants who are in your area who I have personally trained.
Okay, sounds good. Mm-hmm. I guess we're going to have to go take a trip to California.
Or, like I say, nurses are flying in from everywhere. So I'm sure some Georgia nurses are going to come out and learn too.
Yeah, that is good. Congratulations. I'm glad that you came by today and we had to talk it up and find out, you know, there are ways to make some money and do it for yourself.
Yeah.
And keep up the good job. I'm glad you stopped by. We're going to get on out of here. I'm your host, Greg. Keep on striving. Keep on pushing.
Thank you for listening to The Street Life with Greg Russell, here to embrace the ups and downs of life in various communities. Tune in every Friday at 7:30 p.m. right here on Real 1100 AM.
Thank you for listening to another Old Fashioned Health Network show on the Real 1100.